Hey, what's up, guys? Lock on. Hey, man, what's up? So I was going to take a look at this move. Because there was something. Was it this move? There was a move where you get a free one of these or one of these after. I think it was this one, but apparently not. Huh. Or maybe, yeah, probably it's probably on counter hit. No? I'm pretty sure there was something about that move. Or it was this one. That might be a counter hit, this one. Ooh, that's a juicy one. So only one chance to escape, huh? That's neat. Hold on. Okay, so that doesn't work. That's a beautiful one. Now I'm not sure if it's because maybe I need to put it on fast or fastest. Okay, so you can hold from it, but only at the very end. So it's only one mix-up opportunity. Ooh-wee. Look at that. Beautiful. All right, let's not waste too much time here today. I want to get a good amount of matches in. That's all I want. All right. So what's the word on the streets? Anything happening in the video game world, fighting game world? I haven't really taken the time to look around today. You just bought a PS4, right? Because you can download the free version of DOA 5. Sure, you only got like 4 characters, maybe 5. Sometimes they throw a free one in there, but you can definitely just download it for free. If you like to play Kasumi, Ayane, Hayate and Hayabusa. I think those are the 4 free characters. And sometimes they throw a freebie in, like I think the last one was Raidu. Not sure. But you know, I think the full game has been on sale quite a few times. Yeah, the PS Plus thing. That's how they get you. You do need PS Plus to play Tekken 2, right? I mean online. Of course you can play single player, but I'm pretty sure you're gonna need PS Plus for Tekken Online as well. Yeah, it's kind of weird, right? I mean, PC has been doing the internet for so long before consoles, and then consoles come along and they're like, yeah, we're gonna keep it on our own network. And, oh yeah, because we want to keep you off the complete internet, you're gonna have to pay for it. Like reverse logic. But you know, in the end, it's all about keeping you on a platform, right? I mean, imagine you have a PS4 and an Xbox. Most people are not rich enough to pay PlayStation Plus and Xbox Live. You're gonna choose one. So you're probably gonna pick one where your friends are or your family or whatever. And since you're all on the same platform and you're paying the whole time for that, you're probably gonna stay there as well. And that's what they want. They want to keep you Well, that and they're probably, as usually, with hardware, they're taking a big hit on the hardware. They're not making any, usually they're not making any or not much profit on the consoles themselves. But then of course the games and the PS Plus and whatever, that's where the big money is. Another stage selection. Why? Pick random. It's not that hard. Yesterday we had a guy who played Alpha, and every time he picked Alpha, he also picked the stage with extra ground damage. So Alpha's throw did extra damage. There we go. No holes, huh? Good cheer. I think we got a kind of a new player on our hands here. Which is fine, right? You gotta start somewhere. Yeesh, training stage? Ugh. Get ready! I think he needs to block. Man, that's gotta be rough, right? Starting to play this game like right now. It's gonna be a real tough time to really start from zero. I guess most people still playing this game are already at least somewhat advanced. I think that's like the most difficult thing with any fighting game, period. Just finding people on the same level as you. Or like, slightly better. So you can learn. But when you're playing a fighting game against someone way weaker than you, you're not gonna learn anything. And if you play against someone way better than you, then you're also probably not gonna learn anything. It's too much of a difference. And that's also why a lot of people complain about fighting games, right? When the game releases, a lot of people say like, well, I'm just gonna wait for the Game of the Year edition, I'm gonna wait for, you know, discounts, whatever, right? And that's all fine, but for me the biggest reason to get into a game on launch is at that point the playing field is the most even. There's gonna be a lot of people learning the game, a lot of people, you know, trying stuff out, getting to know the game. And you know, if you're really serious about becoming better at a fighting game, probably starting like right at day one when new game releases in a series, that's probably the best moment to start. Just because everyone at that point is starting. Sure, there's some veterans who are gonna, you know, fly through the newbie ranks, no problem. But that's just that, right? They're gonna be out of rank in no time, and all that's left is people learning the game. Perfect time to start. But unfortunately, it comes at a cost. These days, a game does not release without season passes, DLC, whatever, right? And I kind of do like the the approach they did with DOA 5, right? Where you got a free version. Man, a free version. So even, I mean, you got a couple of characters free, and if those are the ones you want to play, even better, then you can literally play for free. Even if you just want to pick one other character, I believe it was like $5. That's a great deal if you know you're gonna play one character. Whew, it's gonna be one of those days, huh? Waiting around forever. Right, before I forget, let's set up a random chat blocker. Man, this is the best trick I ever learned. Creating an empty party because it disables other voice chat in game. Man, I have used that so many times. Not only in like DOA, but if you're playing other games with free voice chat. I mean, I need to be really in the mood to listen to, you know, some guy complaining about whatever, hearing a kid scream in the background, hearing music blasting through someone's mic. I can really miss that when I'm gaming. And waiting it is. So right, like I asked before, is anything news we're talking about today? Anything happening that we can discuss? Let's take a peek at what the news today is. All right, Forge, no problem. And it seems like people are really digging that Spider-Man game, that new one, that's on the horizon. Dude, where is everyone? Let's take a peek at the lobbies. Look at this. Largest held. Why? Large held. Why? Normal. Only two rounds. Why? Largest again. Why? Look, this is more like it. Let's see if it's worth anything. Alright, let's join. At least we'll get a match at some point. Alright, so suddenly I'm up. I think we got someone who's AFK. AFK. Ooh. Loading time longer than usual. Get ready, fight! Should have seen it coming. Out of the air? Yeesh. Man, this is gonna take forever, right? Man, I don't know what's worse, right? Waiting in a lobby myself? Or waiting and watching these guys? Well, I have a feeling this is gonna be a quick one. Ooh, the fuzzy.
Damn.
And I've never really seen anyone play Naotora either, right? I mean, learning the character now is such a waste. Nice, the clutch hold at the end. Well, not hold, the clutch punish throw. Still not sure what's better though, waiting like this for a match. Ooh. Ooh, the lag. Let's hope that's not a match for me as well. Even though I'm not playing, it's hard to look at. Yikes. Couldn't even say get ready, fight. The fight bit got lagged out. Yeesh. The range on that kick. Oh boy, Akira. All right, good shit, good shit. Nice, very nice, the crouch, I like it. Beautiful, beautiful. Ew, Hayate. Ugh. But we got this. I hope. I'm not too familiar with Hayate's moves. Nice hold. Did not expect a high hold from him. Okay. Dude. But like I said, I'm not too familiar with his moveset. So all the weird ninja shit, the teleports. That's usually how it is, right? With all the Hayabusas and Hayates and everyone. As long as you can't deal with the teleports, they're probably gonna win. Because it's an incredible evasive tool. Let's boot up our own lobby again. And you know what? Let's put in the name, because I feel like it gets more people in some way. Well, I suppose it might scare away people as well. If they've seen the stream before and they don't want to be on stream. Man, we desperately need more people playing. We really do. Yeah, to be honest, I'm kind of surprised, right? I really expected, like, the DOA 6 news, the reveal and everything. Maybe, you know, it ignited the DOA passion in some people again. And more people started playing DOA 5 again, but apparently not true. Guess everyone is just happy waiting, you know, probably busy playing Tekken, waiting for Soul Calibur, and then playing DOA 6. But it's kind of the same for me. I'm playing DOA now, but the moment Soul Calibur releases, whew, it's game over DOA. Not because I don't like it, but because Soul Calibur is gonna take all the time and everyone is gonna be playing it. And it's gonna be great times. Great times. By the way, as always, if anyone's watching and want to join, you're always welcome. Here we go, that's the guy from before. Ooh, he's back for the salty rerun. Yeesh.
Yes.
Alright, let's see what we can do here.
Get ready. Hi, hi.
Woohoo! Nice. Man. Should have done a different throw, right? That's the worst throw I could have done. All right. All right, Bass, interesting. Though switching on the win. Kind of a bitch move. Beautiful. Dude. I can't believe that hit. I'm dead. The wind switch. Dude. Alright, lucky, lucky. Dude, I can't believe that hit while I'm midair. There we go, there we go. It's not over yet. Alright, so he doesn't have an infinite supply of characters. Good news, that means I can get used to them. Alright, the troll panic. Downstairs? Oh my god, he's so lucky. That missed? Oh my god. Dude, really? That combo though, right? Woo! Beautiful. What? So late. There we go. Be beautiful. Picking the stage yourself again, huh? Beautiful. There we go, there we go. Right in the bag. Alright, this is cool. Feels like an even match. I feel like he has a lot of trouble breaking the fence with Akira. Get ready, fight! Beautiful. Good shit, good shit. Get ready, fight. Noise. Beautiful. The high counter throw. Just pick random. It's not that hard. Yeah. Nice, nice, nice. Man, so close. Beautiful. Even without the power blow, still a useful move, just once in a while. Dude, random, and I got the same costume? That's insane. Get ready, fight! Yeah. Hoo-hoo-hoo! Got him. Yeah, I feel like he's kind of playing really, you know, linear, right? I feel like most of his attacks are just straightforward. If you can just, you know, kind of guess the distance he's gonna go. Yeesh. Get ready, fight. Dude, what am I doing? I should have just done a mid punch and it was over. Noise. Man, I feel this game, you can learn so much about your character, right? But I feel this game, more than any other fighting game, really rewards you for getting to know your opponent's tendencies. And, you know, to lure them into traps, stuff like that. Alright, he's bringing out the weird ones. What? Alright, so that happened. Let's go crazy one time and play some Tina. Gotta watch out though. There we go. And that's how easy it is, right? If you play with one character all the time and then suddenly switch. And he's been doing that the whole time. So I thought I'd join in. Alright, Neo Tango again. We need to watch out. I don't know her attack, so I just gotta block more in general. Though she does have some nasty guard breaks in there. Boom! Beautiful. Beautiful. Hey, what's up, man? Woo. Woo! Nice hold. Ouch. Out of the air? Hey, what's up, James? Wow, nice. That would have been a power blow. Oh my god. Hey, thanks for the follow, Killua Shigeharu, dude. Sorry for butchering your name. Killua Shigeharu. There we go, much better. Ooh, Elliot? I mean Kasumi and Tina. Yeesh, that was not what I wanted to do. All right. All right, good shit. Nice mix-ups. Get ready. the throw. Downstairs? Alright, alright. Dude. Alright, alright, I'm doing stupid shit. I'm doing stupid shit. DOA 4, man. That's probably the DOA I played the least. I did play her in DOA 4, but I didn't play DOA 4 a lot. I don't even think I played 4 online at all. So, you know, 4 is the one I can say the least about. Can't seem to get a hold on his moves. I'm dead. Oh, nice block. Dude, what? Hold. Alright, so after all this time he finds the character that I'm having trouble to beat. But it's only a matter of time. We just need to learn his patterns. Like that. That's a very common one he's doing. Big throw. What?
What?
Man, that was whack. The range on that? Completely whack. Tony the Tiger? Oh shit. Dude, he's sharp. Weird hole. That was weird. A low hole after that move. Either he must have really expected that, or he's just throwing out random holes. Alright, the problem is I can get a good stun loop going, and he can, so... Dude, that stupid wall move barely works at all. It fails so much, it's ugly. This is an uphill battle. Now, of course, the difference is he clearly knows Kasumi pretty well. Elliot, I've barely, this is probably like the first or second person ever that I've seen him use. Nice combo. Why did that not hit? Wow. Wow. Whoa. Dude, he's so fucking lucky. Nice block. Yeesh. Dude, that's insane. Really? Oh my god. An animation? You mean like drawing it or... Hey, what's up, Daniel? Hail, hail, the gang's all here. This is gonna hurt. Okay, he... Interesting mix-up, but he could have done a way better combo. Blender, nice. Yeah, I'm not familiar with her moves. I'm just throwing out holds, and of course, if you just throw them out, you're not gonna win, ever. And for once, he doesn't do anything. Yeah, I'm playing on PS4. That's pretty much the only place where there's still people playing on... we're still playing DOA. What? Why did that combo fail? That was bullshit. So I wonder what you can do against that one move where he does three punches, the guard breaks, and then continues. See that one. What can you do against that? Because that's how he's getting me a lot. Yeah, sure, Lacan, no problem. Let me just have one match with this guy, and then I'm probably gonna take a very short break, and then we'll play. But first, this guy. Great start. I can't believe that's faster than punches, than Kasumi's jabs. This guy. Good guess. Alright, I'm just gonna take a quick break and then we'll look into that match, Lacan. Alright guys, be right back. I got you all night on my mind. Alright, we back. I received a message. Alright, I'm gonna quickly take a look at the message, but I'm gonna hide the screen for just a second. Don't wanna dox anyone here. Oh, it's a guy from before. No worries then. Dude. Yeah, do you have the PS Plus? Don't forget about the PS Plus. That's weird. So in what menu are you? Like over here in the main menu? You can select this, or you can select it but it won't connect, or what's going on? Let's tech support this shit. But he just got his PS4, right? I mean, the privacy stuff was, it was not that long ago, but could be. I didn't get any message, so must have been a while ago. It's currently being installed. Huh. But the download is already done. Yeah, right. Some games do that, right? Where they install like a part of the game, but not everything. So you can already boot up the game and play like training mode or whatever. Yeah. It's kind of a stupid system because, you know, Sony made it that way, so like the idea was, yeah, you can start playing the tutorial of some game while it downloads the rest in the background, so you can start playing quicker. But most developers just let you get to the menu and that's it. Yeah, but he's not installing from disk. He downloaded the free version, the Core Fighters, whatever it's called. But yeah, it's possible that it's still downloading. which sucks. Yeah, but digital games do the same thing. They download a couple of, you know, the first X amount of gigabytes. Well, I can try. What's your username, your PSN name? Because I think I need to add you as a friend to invite you. Not entirely sure. Search. Oh yeah, I can search. Moonlight Dusk. The one without the numbers, I'm guessing. But I'm guessing if the game is really still installing, then you're probably out of luck. Man. If I would make a fighting game, or scratch that, if I would make any game, right? If I would make a game, I would try to implement a function where you can just invite people from chat. Where I can just invite in chat, like, boom, invite them to the game I'm playing right now. That would be sick. That's something that needs to happen. All right, here we go. By the way, Lockhan, what's your experience in the Away? Since you just downloaded it, is this literally the first time you've ever played the Away? Oh, okay. Here we go. Alright, this is actually interesting. Very first match. And it's a Ninja Gaiden map. Thank you. GG. Man, are you sure it's the very first time you've played DOA? I think you're doing pretty well for a very first time. Oh, alright, alright. That makes a lot more sense. Bagoosh. Well, isn't the game like pretty often on sale? Though the sale is probably still like 20 bucks. Dude, the tiger, did you see that? Unbelievable. During my power blow, the tiger. Yeah, true, the prices are really weird. Well, dude, you've literally played 3 matches. I mean, sure, you've played DOA before, but you're gonna have to learn. By the way, when your health is at 50%, you know, it starts blinking red. That's when you can do the super attack, right? The power blow. Which is, for most characters, something like back punch plus kick, or down back punch plus kick, usually something with punch plus kick. Though Ayane might be the exception to the rule. She might have different buttons. I'm not sure about her. Beautiful. GG's, GG's. Man, I kinda wanna actually learn Momiji, but I'm kinda scared that she's not gonna be in DOA 6, which at that point, rather learn someone who is gonna be in DOA 6 Nice dodge. You think so? I would think if Momiji is in, then Rachel's gonna be in as well. I can't imagine it's one of them. If they're gonna go for Ninja Gaiden characters, they're probably gonna put in both. But I'm actually not sure on my DOA history here, because Rachel's moveset is the one from the Halo character from DOA 4, right? Modified a little bit. But is Momiji an original moveset? There we go. But yeah, Momiji's moveset is pretty fun. I mean, Rachel is fun as well, but she's kinda limited. She doesn't have that many moves. But Momiji's interesting, it's fun. Well, tier lists, I've never been that big on tier lists.
Get ready,
Woo! A little bit of lag. Eat that tree. Beautiful. Get ready. Yeah, we almost had the tree. Almost had him. Well, Daniel, look. There is a difference, of course, in the tier list. Some characters just are gonna be statistically better than others, but skill is still a defining factor. There's a lot of good players with characters that shouldn't be high up there, and still they do it. Because usually what happens is that characters on the top of the tier lists have a bullseye on them, so people train against them. While someone on the bottom of a tier list, you know, you can get away with some stuff maybe. Nice throw. Ooh, nice. Get GG, it's very close. Tron, how does that... That doesn't explain tier lists at all. In fact, if you always believe it's either knowledge or skill that's the difference, then literally tier lists don't matter. Almost downstairs. Okay, now we're really going downstairs. Dude, I keep forgetting I need to press a button during that. GG, there we go. All right, good shit. Yeah, Tron, that's definitely a big part of the tier list conversation, right? The tools. But there's so many factors in a real match. Booty. Well, like I said before, if players pick or learn to play according to tier lists, then a character at the bottom of the tier list, there's less chance your opponent really knows the ins and outs. But of course that's not like a fact, right? It's just, it's more common that a character very low on tier lists, that people have less experience against them because nobody plays them. Yeah, GG's Lacan, GG's. Or you know, you have like the like those freak moments where there's someone who plays a certain character so different that they become known for it. Like, but those are of course exceptions. In the big scheme of things, the tier list is of course a useful tool, and there's a lot of truth to it. The thing is, I don't know how tier lists in DOA are made, but I know for Tekken, they're usually based on death matches, right? So characters that are good in long, long sets usually come out better than characters that might be like more of a, you know, get a couple of wins in quick and that's about it. But those are potentially really dangerous in tournaments. But that's Tekken. I have no idea how the tier lists in DOA are being made or how they're calculated. Well, a tier list is always going to be an opinion, right? There's no... Well, maybe you can mathematically look at it, like these characters have these tools, these characters have all but one of those tools, so they're technically one step better. You can look at it like that, but... In my opinion, if you're looking to play, like if you boot up this game for the first time and you want to pick a character, I would not advise to pick a tier list and pick someone high of the list. I always say just pick any character you like the most, because that's the one you're gonna be stuck with, that character for hundreds of hours. In training mode, in matches, you name it. Yeah, true, and even in tournaments, you know, even if you don't look at the beginner, the lag, the mashing, even then, she's top tier. Curious to see how she'll end up in DOA 6. If she's still as strong, if they're gonna nerf her or buff everyone else. I I mean, as someone who plays Kasumi, if I look at the footage and the move list, more importantly, the move list from Evo, she has really gained a lot of tools that make her, you know, that she's really lacking now. Yeah, well, I guess that's the idea, right? DOA 6 is all about getting in that esports. Anyway, guys, I'm gonna wrap up for today. It was a good one today. We had some good matches. We had fun. We even got a virgin DOA 5 player. Woo! Wild ride. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching as usual. Hope you guys enjoyed, because I did. And of course, to everyone watching, if you want to see more DOA, you can always follow so you get the notification when I'm online. Yeah, enjoy your days / evenings, and I'll see you guys around. Bye.